Hi, first graders. This is Miss Kim. I'm so excited to read with you today. Today, we're going to talk about what good readers do, and one thing they do is retell. Readers retell. They retell the important parts, and they use first, next, last. It reminds me of this song, and it goes like this. What do good readers do? They remember and retell. How do you retell? They say the important parts. Say what? You know, beginning, middle, end. Okay, tell me the important parts. First, next, last. And Elijah over here is going to be playing on the side and also listening to the retell. Okay? Let's say real quick, say hi. Hi, first graders. Is that your hello? He's also going to be thinking about what happens first, next, last. All right, Elijah, you're going to chill out over here and be part of our first grader read aloud. Okay. The book we're reading today is called Stella Luna by Janelle Cannon. Make a connect sign quietly if you've read this book before. Sometimes you can practice with books you've already read or stories you're familiar with, and that will help you retell. All right, here we go. In a warm and sultry forest, sultry means kind of hot, in a forest far, far away, there once lived a mother fruit bat and her new baby. Oh, how mother bat loved her soft, tiny baby. I'll name you Stella Luna, she crooned. Each night, Mother Bat would carry Stella Luna clutched to her breast as she flew out in search of food. So here she's carrying Stella Luna. One night, as Mother Bat followed the heavy scent, the smell of ripe fruit, an owl spied her on silent wings. The powerful bird swooped down upon the bats. Dodging and shrieking, Mother Bat tried to escape, but the owl struck again and again, knocking Stella Luna into the air. Her baby wings were as limp and useless as wet paper. So imagine this paper was wet. That's how her wings felt like. Down, down she went, faster and faster into the forest below. Oh no. The dark, leafy tangle of branches caught Stella Luna as she fell. Oh, phew. One twig was small enough for Stella Luna's tiny feet. Wrapping her wings about her, she clutched the thin branch, trembling with cold and fear. Oh, that's a vocabulary word. Mother, Stella Luna squeaked, where are you? By daybreak, the baby bat could hold on no longer. Down, down, she dropped. Elijah startled too. He's like, really? Flump! Stella Luna landed head first in a soft, downy nest, startling the three baby birds who lived there. Stella Luna quickly clambered from the nest. Elijah's going potty. Stella Luna quickly clambered from the nest and hung out of sight below it. She listened to the babble of the three birds. What was that? Cried Flap. I don't know, but it's hanging by its feet, chirped Flitter. Shh, here comes Mama, hissed Pip. And there's Stella Luna upside down in the nest. So what happened in the story so far? I'm gonna give you some time to think. What happened in the story so far? First. Many, many times that day, Mama Bird flew away, always returning with food for her babies. Stella Luna was terribly hungry, but not for the crawly things Mama Bird brought. Finally, though, the little bat could bear it no longer. She climbed into the nest, closed her eyes, and opened her mouth. Blop! In dropped a big, green grasshopper. Stella Luna learned to be like the birds. She stayed awake all day, and she slept at night. She ate bugs, even though they tasted awful. Her bat ways were quickly disappearing, except for one thing. Stella Luna still liked to sleep hanging by her feet. Once, when Mama was away, the curious baby birds decided to try it too. When Mama Bird came home, she saw 8 tiny feet gripping the edge of the nest. Eek! She cried. Get back up here this instant. You're going to fall and break your necks. The birds clambered back into the nest, but Mama Bird stopped Stella Luna. You are teaching my children to do bad things. I will not let you back into this nest unless you promise to obey all the rules of this house. Stella Luna promised. She ate bugs without making faces. She slept in a nest at night, and she didn't hang by her feet. Stella Luna behaved as a good bird should. All the babies grew quickly. Soon the nest became crowded. Mama Bird told them it was time to learn to fly. One by one, Pip, Flitter, Flap, and Stella Luna jumped from the nest. Their wings worked. I'm just like them, thought Stella Luna. I can fly too. I can fly too. Pip, Flitter, and Flap landed gracefully on a branch. Stella Luna tried to do the same. She probably made sounds like Elijah's making too. Ooh, how embarrassing. She almost fell off. So, what happened in the story so far? What happened in the story so far? First, next. I'll tell you one thing I like to do. Sometimes I like to go back and just look through the pictures and the words to help me remember what are the important parts of the story so far. I will fly all day, Stella Luna told herself. Then no one will see how clumsy I am. The next day, Pip, Flitter, Flap, and Stella Luna went flying far from home. They flew for hours, exercising their new wings. The sun is setting, warned Flitter. We had better go home or we will get lost in the dark, said Flap. But Stella Luna had flown far ahead and was nowhere to be seen. The three anxious birds went home without her. All alone, Stella Luna flew and flew until her wings ached and she dropped into a tree. I promised not to hang by my feet, Stella Luna sighed. So she hung by her thumbs and soon fell asleep. She didn't hear the soft sound of wings coming near. Hey, a loud voice said. Why are you hanging upside down? Stella Luna's eyes opened wide. She saw a most peculiar face. I'm not upside down. You are, Stella Luna said. Ah, but you're a bat. Bats hang by their feet. You are hanging by your thumbs. So that makes you upside down, the creature said. I'm a bat. I'm hanging by my feet. That makes me right side up. Stella Luna was confused. Mama Bird told me I was upside down. She said I was wrong. Wrong for a bird, maybe, but not for a bat. More bats gathered around to see the strange young bat who behaved like a bird. Stella Luna told them her story. You ate bugs, stuttered one. You slept at night, gasped another. How very strange, they all murmured. Wait, let me look at this child. A bat pushed through the crowd. An owl attacked you? She asked. Sniffing Stella Luna's fur, she whispered, You are Stella Luna. You are my baby. You escaped the owl? Cried Stella Luna. You survived? Yes, said Mother Bat as she wrapped her wings around Stella Luna. Come with me, and I'll show you where to find the most delicious fruit. You'll never have to eat another bug as long as you live. What happened in the story so far? What happened in the story so far? Elijah's thinking too. First. Next. Another next. And then. But it's nighttime, Stella Luna squeaked. We can't fly in the dark or we will crash into the trees. We're bats, said Mother Bat. We can see in darkness. Come with us. Stella Luna was afraid, but she let go of the tree and dropped into the deep blue sky. Stella Luna could see. She felt as though rays of light shone from her eyes. She was able to see everything in her path. Soon the bats found a mango tree, and Stella Luna ate as much of the fruit as she could hold. I'll never eat another bug as long as I live, cheered Stella Luna as she stuffed herself full. I must tell Pip, Flitter, and Flap. The next day, Stella Luna went to visit the birds. Come with me and meet my bat family, said Stella Luna. Okay, let's go, agreed Pip. They hang by their feet and they fly at night, and they eat the best food in the world, Stella Luna explained to the birds on the way. As the birds flew among the bats, Flap said, I feel upside down here. So the birds hung by their feet. Wait until dark, Stella Luna said excitedly. We will fly at night. Let's see. Oh, I noticed birds hanging upside down with the other bats. When night came, Stella Luna flew away. Pip, Flitter, and Flap leapt from the tree to follow her. I can't see a thing, yelled Pip. Neither can I, howled Flitter. So many vocabulary words. Ah, shrieked Flap. They're going to crash, gasped Stella Luna. I must rescue them. Vocabulary word. Stella Luna swooped about, grabbing her friends in the air. She lifted them to a tree, and the birds grasped a branch. Stella Luna hung from the limb above them. Here she is rescuing her bird friends. We're safe, said Stella Luna. Then she sighed. Oh, I wish you could see in the dark, too. We wish you could land on your feet, Flitter replied. Pip and Flap nodded. They perched. They sat in silence for a long time. How can we be so different and feel so much alike? Mused Flitter. Muse means to wonder. And how can we feel so different and be so much alike? Wondered Pip. I think this is quite a mystery, Flap chirped. I agree, said Stella Luna. But we're friends. And that's a fact. We are friends, and that's a fact. So readers, what happens to Stella Luna in this story? Now we can think about, in this story, what happened first, next, last. All right, readers, remember that one thing you can do with the books that you read is retell the important parts using first, next, last. This helps you understand the story and also enjoy what you're reading a little bit more. You can also try this with TV shows and movies or any story that you know of, even stories that you've wrote in your journals. Sometimes I retell the important parts of books I've read or movies I've seen to my husband, Mr. Ben, or now I'm going to share with Elijah. So until next time, bye-bye. Say retell the important parts first, next, last. Ooh.